While Eva couldn't stop smiling, sure of her victory, Kraus let out a gloating laugh to show how relaxed he was.
とても良い話じゃないか。私もお前たちとの関係が疎遠になっていたことには非常に心を痛めていた。この条件を飲むことによって兄弟間の関係が再び友好なものにできるなら、それはとても嬉しいことだよ。喜んで話に乗らせてもらおうじゃないか。喜べローザ。取引は成立だ。
Rosa's expression dimmed. It was never a good sign when her brother started talking like this. Eva also keenly picked up on this. That's why she was unable to wipe away a sense of unease, even though Kraus had obediently accepted a deal.
それはひどいじゃないか。私に下心があるというのかね。あるわけもないさ。お前たちと同じだ。Just
the same as all of you. He seemed to empathize that just that one part. The color of Rudo's face darkened. To him, it sounded as though Kraus was saying, I have a plan similar to yours. So Rudolf panicked. He rushed to bring this nearly resolved discussion to a conclusion.
ならいいんだ。じゃあ兄貴、ここにサインをもらえるかい。今の話を書き出した俺たちの誓約書だ。人数分ある。同じ内容に全員がサインする。
Rudolf took four written contracts out of his breast pocket that had the details of their deal written on them. Rudolf took a fountain pen out of his breast pocket and offered it to Kraus. Kraus made as if to accept it, but then, with a small laugh, he drew back his hand without taking it and spoke. As soon Kraus said that single sentence, all of the siblings felt as though something ominous was creeping up their backs at the same time.
ダメよ。もう決まった話よ。黙ってサインを。エヴァ、何を焦っているんだね。もちろんサインはする。お前たちに黄金の分け前75億円分を約束する。親父殿の遺産分配の時、 きれいさっぱり清算することも約束する。だが、一点だけどうしても譲歩してもらいたい部分があるのだよ。何の話だよ。どの点が気に入らねえってんだ。分け前の1割、7億5000万円を即納する点だよ。お前たちの指摘通り、私の財政状況は決して裕福ではない。 数々の先行投資によって未来に必ず回収できると保証されながらも、今のこの時点では火の車であることは認めなければならない。つまり今すぐに動かせる金は全くないということだ。私は無能で詳細の嗅覚も鈍い。お前たちの言うところの弱り目の私には、
7億半も半年で動かせる力はないということだよ。そんなはずはないでしょ。いい加減なことを言ってこの場をごまかす気。
遺産分配時に全て一括で清算する。1割を即納する条件を削除したまえ。 それが私にサインさせるための唯一の条件だ。
クラウス兄さん、この1割はな、あくまでもお兄さんの誠意を図る数字なんやで。本当なら取引の余地もない話や。そこを100歩譲った上で、とりあえず1割の誠意でこの場を丸く収めちゃるっちゅう大サービスなんやで。そう説明した上でそこを断るっちゅうのは、互いの信頼関係にちょいと影を落とすんとちゃいますか。
Hideyoshi had a humble expression on his face and was rubbing his hands together. But his eyes weren't calm at all. Kraus had already seen through to the shadow in the depths of those eyes.
お前たちは何を焦っているのか？それとも何に怯えているのかね？どうぞ。私にだけは教えてくれんか。他の兄弟たちには内緒でこっそりと。
別に私は。
よせよ兄貴。俺たちは兄貴がサインするかしないかしか聞いてない。妙な勘繰りも交渉もなしで。
ほう、私には交渉の余地もないと。立場が弱いのは私の方で、公平な関係ではないと、そう言いたいのかね。
Shivers began to crawl up Rudolph's back. He began to feel himself getting overwhelmed by the height of his brother's completely insurmountable wall and the long shadow that had existed since they were children.
取引は公平な関係であるべきじゃないのか。この取引は私にとっては弟や妹たちと長いこと失ってきた信頼を取り戻し、兄弟愛を深め合うもの。それは私にとって緊急に解決したかった心のしこりだ。それが今日解決できてとても嬉しいと思う。だがお前たちもこの取引を急ぎ締結することがとても嬉しいんじゃないのか。
Kraus stared at each of his siblings. They avoided his gaze with an animal-like instinct. Only Hideyoshi was slow in avoiding it. So he was caught by Kraus' gaze.
Hideyoshi-nisan, あなたの会社は非常に好調子だそうじゃないですか。トントン拍子で上場を果たし、業績も株価も右肩上がり。実にお羨ましいことです。
うちの人の話は関係ないでしょ。
だが株主たちに対する還元を怠ったのが悪かった。そして上場した時に足回りを固めきらなかったのもまずかった。気づいた時にはたちの悪い連中に自社株をだいぶ買い集められていたらしいじゃないですか。
なんでそんな話知っとるんや。
秀吉さんと同じですよ。私に融資する人間などいないと裏を取れる程度に、私も秀吉さんの裏を取れるのです。そんな不思議があることはないじゃないですか。
Kraus grinned broadly. In contrast, Hideyoshi's face was rapidly turning pale. Hideyoshi's company was a restaurant chain, management company that he'd started from nothing. Thanks to Hideyoshi's management efforts, the company had achieved success repeatedly, expanding its range, and a petition to make it stock-listed. A stock-listed company had recently succeeded. The greatest advantage of being in the stockholding system is that you can sell stock certificates and gain a large amount of financing. That amount tends to be far greater than a business normal profits. So, this is an extremely effective way to gather massive funds to expand the business even further. However, in exchange for financing the company, the stockholders gained certain rights. They're given rights that allow them to observe and guide the company they've invested in, leading to profits even greater than their original investments. This right is guaranteed to the stockholders, and they sometimes use it to dismiss ineffectual management. The right allows them to keep an eye on management and prevent the money they've invested in the company from going to waste. However, if they use it forcibly, they can eject the former management and take over the company. After all, dismissing management and nominating new management are powers held by the general body of all shareholders. That power is determined by the majority decision of the stockholders. And people who hold more stock get to cast more votes. In other words, if some person or group holds a majority of the stock, they can freely chase out the old management and make the president anyone they'd like. If they want, it's also possible for them to make themselves president. Most companies take various defensive measures to stop malicious people from buying up the stock and threatening their position. Like ensuring that lots of stock is bought by those close to them, such as company employees. However, Hideyoshi's company had only recently become stock listed, and he hadn't had time to strengthen those defensive measures. Or maybe Hideyoshi was so engrossed in the management of his company that he couldn't probably understand the dangers of being stock listed. It's hard to say whether he should be viewed as a kind-hearted manager immersed in the work of management, or a foolish manager who had his feet swept out from under him. In other words, there existed some people who wouldn't let him get away with that naivety unscathed. They began repeatedly buying up stock in Hideyoshi's company, rapidly gaining such strength that they couldn't be ignored. They then sent anonymous documents to the shareholders in an attempt to gain control of a majority. The documents read, "The current management continues to make pointless investments and is ignoring the needs of the stockholders." Let us force the current management to retire, cut the current wasted investments, and let this company be born again as one that gives more back to the stockholders. It's very difficult to make the actual state of a company's management known. The fruits of Hideyoshi's sleepless nights and constant concern for his company were cruelly distorted, and he lost the trust of his stockholders. Thanks to these efforts, this group had almost collected a majority of the company's stock. At that point, even Hideyoshi noticed and started to buy back the stock, but the stockholders realized that the company was undergoing an acquisition maneuver, and each demanded a ridiculous price for the shares that Hideyoshi was trying to buy back. They continually tortured Hideyoshi, who had no leeway in the negotiation of the price. One of the certainties of capitalism is that the price will rise when two parties vie for the same thing. And one of the certainties of democracy is that a majority controls everything. So in the end, whoever manages to buy up the most stock wins. Put another way, whoever has the most money wins. Unless Hideyoshi could obtain a large sum of money at this critical time, he could easily lose all he had built so far. Therefore, more than anything else, he wanted a lot of money right now. He couldn't wait for the division of Kinzo's inheritance since no one knew when he would die.
ルドルフの方も最近は大変だそうじゃないかね。海外は怖いとよく言うが、本当にそうらしいな。アメリカの裁判は極めて感情的に決まる。彼らは外国人に寛大な判決など出しはしない。先方と和解した方が結局は安上がりになると弁護士に忠告を受けたんじゃないのかね。何の話？
まあ、仕事上のトラブルさ。大したことじゃない。金でキリのつく話さ。Kirie
immediately guessed the meaning behind the subtle expression on Rudolph's face. Her husband had gotten wrapped up in some kind of trouble without her knowledge, and had been worrying over it alone.
その通りさ。 世の中なんだって金で蹴りがつく。失った兄弟の絆だって買い戻せるようにな。アメリカは権利侵害などにはうるさい国だ。だが金さえあれば何でも和解できる。資本主義万歳だよ。もっとも和解金は数百万ドルにも及びそうだとの噂もあるがね。
Rudolph had been building a large amount of wealth with a certain type of niche industry. However, a niche is a niche. It definitely wasn't a business exposed to the light of day. An American corporate giant was trying to accuse Rudolph's company of violating their rights. For various reasons, it was thought that victory for Rudolph in this trial would be extremely unlikely, and he was being forced into an all-out surrender. But even so, there was a way for this to be resolved with money. If he could just pay that money, it might still be painful, but he'd be able to pick himself back up. But if he didn't pay, he'd lose everything. Therefore, more than anything else, he wanted a lot of money right now.
ローザは清く正しい妹だ。危険なマネーゲームなどには手を出さない。だが、お人よしな性分が災いしたんじゃないかね。連帯保証人は気安く引き受けるものではないと思うがね。
Rosa uncharacteristically laid bare her emotions and yelled. After all, no one was supposed to know that. As Kraus watched, he let slip a muffled laugh. Without exception, every one of them, more than anything else, wanted a lot of money right now. In other words, the situation had been reversed. After all, the person their younger siblings were threatening was the only one who had no urgent need for a large sum of money. The other three, however, wanted a lot of money quickly, no matter the cost. In other words, the longer it took to establish this deal, the better position Kraus would be in. Kraus was extremely sly. He had known of the Achilles heel from the beginning. Even so, he had not been certain. Therefore, he had hidden his knowledge until the very end, striking back only after analyzing their attitudes.
私もできることなら、可愛い弟や妹たちの危機に金を工面してやりたいと思っているよ。だが、残念なことに持ち合わせがなくてね。7億半もの大金が工面できるスポンサーに心当たりがあるなら、先にそちらを当たってもらいたいのだ。
Krause's elated words were so obviously detached from what he actually felt. The other siblings could do nothing more than listen, grinding their teeth. If they could think of a sponsor that convenient, they wouldn't have kept up this charade. They had entered this huge battle specifically because they had exhausted all other options. Krause's slow, gloating laugh began to fill the parlor. The younger siblings, who had been driving the oldest brother into a corner until a moment ago, could do nothing more than grimace and grind their teeth.
Eva!
Jodan ja nai wa. Niisan ni kari nanka tsukureru mon desu ka? Jodan ja nai. Jodan ja nai!
クラウス兄さんを頼ったらどう助けてくれるの？言ったではないか。私にできるのは他のスポンサーを探すだけだよ。もちろん利息を融通してもらえるようには最大限交渉するがね。<笑>ちくしょう。
足元見やがって。あなた、落ち着いて。落ち着いてるぜ。俺は極めて冷静だぜ。クソったりが。Kiria
grabbed her husband's hand. But that action made him feel even more pitiful, so Rudolf shook it off. Cross laughed as though watching something highly amusing.
こんな時、本当に親父殿の隠し黄金が見つかればいいのだがね。そうすればすぐに25億ずつをこの場で切り分けてやれるのだが、残念残念残念至極。非常に極めて実にどうしようもなく残念だ。今宵は兄弟みんなで酒を酌み交わしながら、親父殿ベアトリーチェの秘文の謎を
4人揃えば、きっと解けない謎はないはずさ。<笑><笑>